Hi, my name is Chris, and welcome to the BIM Corner channel. Thanks to our community learngrasshopper.com, I met plenty of engineers learning Grasshopper and found out what challenges they have. In many cases, the biggest issue is lack of knowledge of Grasshopper fundamentals. That's why I will continue this series about Grasshopper basics that everyone should know. Enjoy the third episode. We can glean some information about the state of each object based on their color. Let's take a look at Grasshopper's default color coding system. A component which contains neither warning nor errors, it shows in the light gray. This color object indicates that everything is worked properly with the parameter. A component which has been selected will be shown in the light green color. If the selected component has generated some geometry with the Rhino's scene, this will also turn green to give you some visual feedback. A component which preview has been disabled is shown in slightly darker gray. To disable the preview for multiple components at the same time, first select the desired component and then toggle to the disable preview icon, blindfolded man. A component that has been disabled is shown in a dull gray. To disable a component, you may right-click on the component and toggle to disable button, or you may select the desired components, right-click anywhere on the canvas and select disable. Disable components stop sending data to the downstream components. A component which contains warnings is displayed in an orange box. Any object which fails to collect data is considered suspect in a Grasshopper definition since it is not contributing to the solution. A small balloon at the upper right-hand corner of the object symbolizes that. If you hover the mouse over the balloon, it will reveal information about why the component is giving you a warning. A component which contains at least one error is displayed in red. The error can come either from the component itself or from one of its inputs or outputs. If a Grasshopper component generates some form of geometry, then a preview of this geometry will be visible in the viewport by default. You can choose between turn off preview, wireframe preview, and shaded preview set up as a default. Next to the right, you can find preview selected objects. With this button toggled, Grasshopper will only display geometry that is a part of selected components, even if those components have a preview off state. In order to work with geometry in Rhino that was created in Grasshopper, I mean to select, edit, transform, you must bake it. Baking creates new geometry in the Rhino document based on the current state of the Grasshopper graph. It will no longer be responsive to the changes in your definition. If you need your Grasshopper definition to be independent from a Rhino file, you can do that by changing the way data is inherited and stored in the context menu of a parameter of component input. To change store reference Rhino geometry in the Grasshopper definition itself, right-click a parameter and select Internalize data from the menu. Once you selected Internalize data, any wire will be disconnected from the input. The data has been changed from the violet to persistent and will no longer be updated. Note that this data will be independent from Rhino file.
If you would like to learn and read more about Grasshopper, I have prepared a free Grasshopper guide. 20 pages filled with books, exercises and tutorials about Grasshopper. Everyone will find something for themselves. To download the guide, please click the link in the description below.
Grasshopper has a default color scheme for selected geometry semi-transparent green and unselected semi-transparent red. It is possible to override this color scheme with the document preview settings dialog. Just pick your color and drag it into your icon. Fancy wires. Wires represent the connection that the data flow. Grasshopper can also give us a visual clues as to what is flowing through the wires. To view the different types of line types for the connection wires, you have to activate it. To do this, simply check on the View tab on the main menu bar and select the button labeled Draw Fancy Wires. Fancy wires can tell you a lot of information about what type of information is flowing from a component to another. For example, standard line means one element in one list. Thick line. Line is thicker than the standard one because there flows more data. Through this connection go one list but with several elements. And dashed line shows that data is built with a several list, so-called data tree. There are three wire displays, default display, feigned display, and hidden display. To change the wire display, simply right-click on any input on a component and select one of the views available under the wire display pop-up menu. Panel zoom. When zooming to a panel, a menu appears allowing to change the background, font, and other attributes. These options are also available when you right-click to the panel. Thanks to that, it will be easier to distinguish panels from each other. Especially changing color can significantly change your script visibility.
That's all for today. If you like this video and want to see more in the Grasshopper Basics series, please click the like button and subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, see you next time. Have a good one.